Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is set for one fall. Introducing first, accompanied to the ring by Teddy Long from Baltimore, Maryland. Jump in, Joey Maggs.
Teddy Long back at ringside now as he brings in Jumpin' Joey Maggs, a young man we've watched him view and scout over the past couple of weeks. A dream, if you'll recall, I asked Teddy a couple of weeks ago on Saturday night about Jumpin' Joey Maggs. He really didn't have much to say about him, but talked about the young superstars in WCW and about how they needed some guidance.
Welcome, everybody, to WCW Saturday Night, most watched wrestling program in the world.
His opponent from Brooklyn, New York, the Disco Inferno.
The Disco Inferno. Dream, is your headset on? I didn't know. Okay.
Yeah, I heard you. But, you know, I was excited about getting on here on Saturday night. And to be truthful with you, so the fans understand where I'm coming from, Joey Maggs was the last thing on my mind when we opened up here. But Teddy Long sees something in him, quiet about him. I guarantee you one thing, if he gets a victory over this Disco nut right here, you know what I'm talking about, he will surely change our mind about him.
But Disco Inferno, having trouble disrobing here. There's no doubt about it. One of the more flamboyant, one of the more exciting wrestlers you'll find in WCW. And by golly, in the stands with us is Emmett Smith right behind him. So there's Emmett.
No, that is not Emmett Smith.
Somewhere.
Stop that.
And there you see WCW executives back here this week.
Yeah, that was one of our executives.
Yes, there were.
Yeah.
Hey, everybody is talking about the Christmas season. And that means only one thing to wrestling fans worldwide. That means the granddaddy of them all, Starcade. And can you imagine the two greatest wrestling organizations in the world battling it out for supremacy? WCW and New Japan Pro Wrestling.
Well, WCW is the, where the big boys play, the most dominant wrestling organization in the world. I'm not so sure about New Japan. I think they are trying to make their mark and say they're on the same level with WCW. Great athletes, great Japanese people, great competition. But brother, they coming over here at Starcade, and we're gonna get it on.
Joey. That's what they're doing. They're chanting Joey.
Here with me tonight?
I sure am. There's an elbow right on the bicep, the tricep area of Jumpin' Joey Maggs. Maggs going to have to use his quickness that he's been known for, his agility. And, of course, Disco Inferno is going to have to get rid of his vanity and start wrestling. There's an arm drag takeover. And Disco Inferno very upset. Look at that. Drop toe hold. In with reckless abandon. And Joey Maggs. Obviously, Teddy Long has been doing a little coaching.
Yeah, he's moved up closer, too. He was standing way back, watching the thing from the side. What a show we got today. You talk about Sting and Pippen, our big main event. One match I'm really looking forward to. I know all the fans are going to be stay tuned. I'm talking about one of the Hoffman, Pillman, and Johnny B. Badd with the new doll, Kimberly. And you're right, Joey Maggs looks a lot better. Teddy Long has moved up so he can hear him. Maybe he was shouting at him from way in the back, and he couldn't hear what he was talking about.
Could have been.
Could have been.
To the top of the head, Disco Inferno. We saw this last week against Johnny B. Badd. The intensity that he has, he has picked it up a notch. And he has now got Jumpin' Joey Maggs in a very tough spot.
Well, Joey Maggs, you know, he had some good offense when he come in there, and he was using his head, but right now he's using his head for something else. It's a batting ram for the left hook of the Disco Inferno. Send him for the ride outside.
Starcade is Wednesday, December 27th at 8 o'clock. That's 8 o'clock Eastern Time, 2 days after Christmas. We're all going to be there. It's going to be a tremendous amount of fun as we bring you the superstars of World Championship Wrestling against the superstars of New Japan Pro Wrestling, plus the big triangle match. Will the Macho Man retain the world title, or will it be Flair, Sting, or Luger? One of four men.
Or will it be the Giant? And we're going to talk more about that
later on,
too, because Monday Nitro coming up this week. The Giant get a shot at the Macho Man, Randy Savage. Could be Macho out. You know what I'm talking about? The Giant in the triangle match. Nashville, Tennessee, Tony. The last time we were there, my mom had to call and get us out. Well, she had to call somebody there. What a great town. I introduced you to Loretta Lynn. I introduced you to Dolly Parton.
You
were crazy. You know, I mean, it's going to be a wonderful time for us, because I know you love Nashville. And to hear you sing one more time, it's worth going there, brother.
Was that Loretta Lynn that you introduced me to?
Yes, it was. And you were fumbling over yourself.
I didn't realize that. Reverse chin lock is applied. Jumpin' Joey Maggs has his fans out here. And Disco Inferno trying to get some offense going here against Jumpin' Joey Maggs. It's a great jawbreaker maneuver. It's a kind of a defensive maneuver, but it worked. Max goes down hard from the Disco Inferno. We have, as Dusty said, in this program, Eddie Guerrero against Jerry Lynn. Jerry Lynn returns to action, plus Flying Brian, Johnny B. Badd, and Sting and the Pit Bull, Craig Pittman. That's all in this program. Plus, we'll hear from Flair, Sting, Luger, and the Macho Man, Randy Savage, in this program.
You know what, Tony? Wow, good shot, Joey. Good shot.
Look at Joey. Joey doing a little battling here.
Yeah, he is doing some battling. Right there. Change the tide a little bit. Change the momentum, Joey Maggs.
Joey Maggs trying to get things going here. Now, a little 360 there.
But Teddy Long right there on top of the situation right now. What a great humanitarian and a great man he is for the city of Atlanta, Georgia, and all over the South. And here he is right here with a big boy player on WCW once again. Former manager of the year. No and place to go.
That's right. And a great humanitarian for WCW. Teddy is one of the best. And he has apparently inspired this youngster, Jumpin' Joey Maggs, because Joey Maggs into this match here.
You need a lot of fire in this bus, what he needs to do, and that's what I think he's done.
Well,
you got to do that sometime with kids that have a lot of ability.
Yes, you do. The Disco Inferno held his ground, swinging neck breaker. He got him with that.
Yeah, that's it right there. You can call that one.
But wait a second.
You got to put him away.
He sure does. He has to pin him. You got to pin his shoulders. You can't dance. Once again, the vanity is there, and there is no lateral press. A critical mistake from the Disco Inferno. Can you believe that?
Yeah, after watching him lately, I can believe that. But right now, he might be a day late to Dollar Shot. Come on, Joey.
One, two, and Maggs.
Ready.
One, two, three. Maggs beat him.
Yes, yes, yes. All right.
Jumpin' Joey Maggs, Teddy Long, they celebrate as the Disco Inferno is once again in disbelief.
Unbelievable. Right here, take a quick look at it. You know, he had an opportunity to pin him, but great champions know how to put them in a way. Obviously, he don't. Rolled up, Joey Maggs gets a victory on Saturday night.
We're off and running on a Saturday night here on TBS, and we take you to Mean Gene Okerlund.
We're back on Saturday night, a very impressive Joey Maggs, and I think a lot of credit should be given to my guest at this time, Teddy Long, for the vast improvement of this young man's performance here.
Well, Gene Okerlund, let me say thank you very much. Well, let me say something to you, Joey Maggs. I knew you always had it in you. And let me say something to everybody out there. When I'm in the boys and the girls clubs and out in the communities, I have made a commitment to make a difference in some kids' lives. And my commitment to you, Joey Maggs, is to make a difference in your life.
And he has the ability to turn careers around, and I think you found that out very quickly here, Joey.
Teddy, first of all, I need to thank you. The one thing I've been lacking these last few years is a belief in myself. You taught me how to learn from my mistakes and gave me the confidence I need to win, and I proved that here tonight. And I just feel like with you by my side and this newfound confidence I have in myself, the sky's the limit.
All right, you know, I've been watching this guy since he's been about... Get just a second here. Hey, Disco Inferno.
Let me talk here a minute. All right, it's the Shake Your Booty Tour. I know you got rhythm. This guy's got no rhythm. Let me sell you one of my CDs. It's the hottest thing going today. These things are only $49.95. Hey, look at some of these songs in this, Teddy. Look at this. We got Shake Your Booty. Shake Your Booty Around the Clock. Hey, Cutie, Shake Your Booty. Rudy Tootie, Shake
Your Booty.
What
about it, Teddy?
Joey Maggs. This is what I'm talking about. You have to take this profession serious to be the best that you can be.
Hey, I'm serious, okay? As a matter of fact, why don't you put that bald head of yours and lower it a little bit here so I can check out my hair, see how it looks here, huh?
All right, you happen to have that in 8-track? I've got a 1977 car.
I got the 8-track at home, but this is the CD. It's only $49.95. Buy it while you can.
See a little dancing here from the Disco Inferno.
Hey, hit the music. Everybody wants to see the Disco Inferno dance. Come on, Teddy.
I got one for you, Disco Inferno. Have you heard Hit the Road, Jack? Huh? Have you heard Hit the... That's good. Thank you. Stay tuned. More exciting action here on Saturday night when we come back.
Hey, what happened to my music?
Forget it.